The alveoli, and here's sort of a zoomed in version of the alveoli. They look a lot like the alveoli in the lungs, right? So prolactin actually stimulates milk synthesis from the alveoli. So you have these secretory cells that secrete milk. So you end up with milk in the lumen here. But then you've got to get the milk out of the lumen of the alveoli and eject it. So oxytocin stimulates the milk ejection reflex by stimulating myoepithelial cells. Myo is muscle, so these are epithelial cells associated with muscle. So that can cause ejection of the milk. Let's take a closer look. This is a really nice flowchart that shows you how both hormones are involved in lactation. So there's a tactile response in the nipples. This is the stimulus, and that's caused by the suckling of the infant, which stimulates the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus then is going to synthesize and secrete prolactin-releasing hormone, but it's not going to synthesize and secrete prolactin-inhibiting hormone. It's also going to increase the activity of the neurosecretory neurons, which stimulate the posterior pituitary to release oxytocin. So oxytocin targets the breast. That causes contraction of the myoepithelial cells so the milk can be ejected. Now, prolactin-releasing hormone, when it's synthesized and secreted by the hypothalamus, it's going to stimulate the anterior pituitary to release prolactin, PRL, right? Which then targets the breast as well and causes secretion of the milk by the alveoli. So then that secretion of milk by the alveoli plus the contraction of the myoepithelial cells are what are responsible together for milk ejection. So that concludes the reproductive system.